Timberwolves, and welcome to the fourth annual Hespies.
Hey, did you know Obama's out there?
What? Obama?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, Charles Barkley.
Really?
No.
Jeez. Oh. Okay, well, try it again, I guess. Hello, Timberwolves, and welcome to the fourth annual Hespies, brought to you virtually by Events.
And much too small medical gloves and masks. That's right, folks, we got the virtual Hespies, a good mix of silly, as well as recognition and celebration of the year that was. Happy to see you tonight.
This is harder than it looks.
Yeah.
Maybe a size or two too small.
Okay.
These gloves. There we go. I think we're ready.
You got a measuring tape? This feels close. Danny, you 6 feet yet?
5'10".
Yeah, close enough. Here, come lay on this table.
Oh.
This is there. That's good enough. You ready?
Let's get ready to Hespy!
Is Katie Penuetta, who moves into the top three all-time at Heritage High School in kills and digs. Game of the year, the winner for game of the year is our football team for their exciting season opening win against Evergreen.
Gotta stick with it, trust our coaches, trust our players, and just stick with it.
You got them on big in the second quarter, and they came back at you. You guys kind of figured that they would come back at you in the second half?
Yeah, we knew it was going to be a fight. Evergreen's always a fight every year, so like I said, we gotta stick with it, stick to our coaches, stick to our game plan.
Garoppolo, pressure coming after him as he releases, and it's intercepted by Diggs. Quandre Diggs on the return, and the newly acquired veteran safety.
And now, a special message from defensive back for the Seahawks, Quandre Diggs.
Hey, Timberwolves family, this is Quandre Diggs from the Seattle Seahawks. Just want to say congratulations on a great year. I know things are not going normal, but at the end of the day, we pushed through to be better. We're super proud of you guys. I wish you guys many more blessings, and we just want you guys to keep pushing forward and be great for the community.
You know what I love about sports?
The spirit of competition?
Yes, but I'm thinking of something else.
Is it teamwork?
Well, good also, but no.
I give up.
Brackets.
Oh, brackets.
Brackets.
Yes.
Tonight, we've got 8 contestants in what we're simply calling Hespies Bracket Madness.
Tell them how it works.
I'll tell you how it works.
Yeah.
With COVID-19 doing its own thing, we've had to get creative in how we compete from afar. So each round, we're going to have something a little bit different. We're going to be able to gather without breaking any government rules.
Because rules were made to be broken.
No! No rules were broken.
All right.
No rules were broken. Here's quarterfinal, round one.
Here we have girls and boys golf coach Dwight Patterson in his kitchen making a grilled cheese sandwich.
Oh, that looks delicious.
Look at his focus, his patience. Here comes the flip. Here it comes.
Oh. Oh, he nailed it!
He's going for another! Oh, the double flip!
Ah, wow!
And in this corner, we have award-winning and retired Lita Meyer's dog, Zoe, digging in the sand.
Whoa, look at her go!
You can really tell she's been using the Volt program.
Oh, the strength stands out.
And the dog-like tenacity.
Well, she is a dog.
Yes. Yes, she is.
Boop 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 boop.
I got something for you.
What?
Here's an update on the brackets. The winner from round one was Zoe. And now on to round two.
Está haciendo pizza y está probando las aceitunas. Qué asco me da, pero está bien. Y ahora está cortando la pimienta. Ay, qué sabrosa va a ser la pizza. Qué sabrosa va a ser. ¿Y qué es eso? ¿Qué es eso? ¿Qué es eso? ¡Lo va a poner! ¡Lo va a poner! ¡Va a poner un huevo en la pizza! ¡Gol! ¡Qué sabrosa va a ser! ¡Gol!
Wow. And going against that, we've got three hot dogs on a grill brought to you by Braden Sittman. Huh? That's what it says.
Our next guest is Christine Leahy, a sports journalist. She began her career with the Boston Celtics, then moved on to American Ninja Warrior, sports radio, and then eventually hosting her own interview show. We're happy to have Christine Leahy here at the Hespies.
So, Christine, you've made a career out of interviewing other people and asking great questions. We're going to flip the script tonight and ask you some questions.
Okay. Oh, you can see my little dog in the background. She's making an appearance.
Perfect. Awesome. Special guest. Okay. You grew up a Chicago Bulls fan.
Yes.
And I'm going to assume you've been watching The Last Dance.
Yes.
What's another sports documentary that you think somebody should make?
So Kevin Garnett and his time in Chicago, where he was in high school and his life there. I think there's some really great stories. One of his teammates is a great storyline with him there that I think needs to be done, and it hasn't yet. So someone out there, don't steal that idea.
In doing my research, you graduated from Prairie Ridge High School.
I did.
And what was your mascot?
We were the Wolves,
okay.
The Prairie Ridge Wolves.
Okay, now we are the Heritage Timberwolves.
Oh.
So my question for you is, who wins in a fight, the Wolves or the Timberwolves?
The Timberwolf. Well, that's interesting because I don't know too much about a Timberwolf. Go with the Wolf because it's the original. The okay. Timberwolf seems like a knockoff. So I got to go with the original Big Bad Wolf.
Okay, you may have a point there. All right, you hosted American Ninja Warrior and you saw many great athletes on that show. Who would do better on Ninja Warrior, Coach Gonzalez or Coach Gill?
You know, I've heard some rumors. I think it would have to be Coach Gill. Coach Gill would be the winner, and that's who I would interview at the end of American Ninja Warrior.
I got to accept that answer. You're the expert. Yeah. We feel so sad for the class of 2020. They're missing out on events, but we are committed to holding a traditional graduation once it's safe to do so. You're known for being highly fashionable. Is there anything you can do with a cap and gown to actually make it look cool?
Oh, see, I think a cap and gown is such a cool thing to begin with. You only get to wear one maybe twice in your life. So cool shoes. That's the number one tip. Wear some really cool shoes because that's the only thing that you'll see that's part of your outfit. And then I've seen on the top of the cap, people will do different decorations on the top so people can see. I am more of a classic approach, minimal. So I like just the traditional cap and gown, but I had some very cool shoes. And that can go for guys and girls.
You're big into rap and hip hop.
Yes.
What is Christine Leahy's walk-up song?
Oh, that's a good one. You know, for a while, I would say it was Drake's Jumpman, because that kind of also was like a nod to Jumpman, Michael Jordan, where I grew up. So I'll go with that, or maybe something by DaBaby. That's my new,
okay.
My new go-to.
Okay.
You know DaBaby?
I've got a son who's a junior, so I'll ask him if he.
He probably knows.
Okay. You've been a great role model for empowering women. What advice would you give our female student athletes?
Oh gosh, to stay true to yourself, be strong. Don't feel like you have to be nice. You can be assertive, aggressive, just like the guys, and don't apologize for it and stand up for yourself.
We've got the most successful esports team in the state of Washington.
Yes.
And you're a big supporter of esports. Mm-hmm. In fact, you just interviewed Cypher. I saw on your
YouTube
channel. Yeah.
Yeah.
What video games do you most highly recommend during the COVID shutdown?
Oh, old school, like Mario Kart. I think that was great. Call of Duty. There's a new Call of Duty. It's not so new anymore, is it? But the Call of Duty is really cool right now. But I would say go old school, Mario Kart.
Next school year, Heritage will be putting on Wrestling the Musical.
No way.
A legendary high school wrestling coach who feels threatened by the young female assistant who's just been hired. On a scale of 1 to 10, how intrigued are you about a musical with songs such as Make and Wait and Ringworm?
Oh, Ringworm. That has a whole new take to it now. Yeah. Coronavirus, you should add to that one on right. The mat. Well, that certainly sounds interesting, and I have a lot of WWE friends that would love something like that. It's certainly creative.
You went to college at Boston U, and then you covered Boston sports. Yeah. Who is on your Boston sports figures Mount Rushmore?
Oh gosh, so how many are there? That's four, right?
Four. Yeah.
So I'll go with Tom Brady, Paul Pierce, David Ortiz, and George St. Pierre.
Wow.
Yeah.
George makes the list.
Yeah. You know him, right?
I've heard things. I he was famous around here, but I didn't know that he had made quite the impact there in Boston itself.
Oh, absolutely. We heard about he's a legend.
Sadly, we miss spring sports, but we're hopeful for a comeback in the fall. What advice would you give to a young athlete as they head into summer?
You know, keep your head up. Stay positive. The good news is everyone's in the same boat. So it's not like it was just you who lost your ability to play, but stay in shape if you can. Try to get outside. Do what you can, depending on, you know, what's allowed where you guys are. And just remember, like, everyone's in the same boat. So when you can play sports again, it'll feel that much better, and hopefully you'll appreciate it more since it was taken away from you at one point.
Christine, thank you so much for being a part of our HESPYs. Really appreciate your time. Stay healthy, stay safe. We love what you do. And again, thank you very much.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
Here's an update on the brackets. The winner from round two was Coach Gill with the egg on her pizza. And now, here's quarterfinal round three.
Here we have gold medalist, world champion wrestler, and motivational speaker who visited Heritage this year, Bruce Baumgartner's mustache.
I feel intimidated.
So do I.
And in this corner, it's Lita's dog, Zoe, again, chasing something around. Check it out.
The contestant patiently waits for the gates to open. And it does! Off to the races! The rabbit, hot on the trail! Oh, and Zoe, very close behind her, goes behind the shed! Rabbit, going to make it! Oh, and Zoe, stopped by the fence!
The Easter Bunny got away.
Good morning. I am Petty Officer Second Class James Studdard from the United States Navy. On behalf of the United States Navy, it is our honor to recognize the following student athlete at Heritage High School with the Culture Builder Award, which recognizes a graduating senior whose career as a Timberwolf has been marked by their positive example and year-round commitment into improving the athletics programs on and off the field. Congratulations to Zephin Zabik as this year's honoree. Always remember to never give up. Without commitment, you'll never start. But most importantly, without consistency, you'll never finish. The future is yours. Congratulations.
Hey, good afternoon, class of 2020, staff and faculty members. My name is Staff Sergeant Nguyen, and on behalf of the U.S. Army, it is our honor to recognize the following student athlete at Heritage High School with the Warrior Award, which recognizes a graduating senior who has shown the diverse skill sets of academics, athletics, goal setting, and being a team player. Congratulations to Adria Jones, winner and warrior. I would also like to take this opportunity to congratulate all students on their educational achievements. We are so very proud of everybody's accomplishments and wish everybody nothing but the best in their future endeavors. So with that being said, we hope everybody's staying safe, healthy, and vigilant, all while continuing to strive for greatness. U.S. Army, Staff Sergeant Nguyen, go Army.
Hey, good evening. This is Sergeant Rafferty with the Marines, and on behalf of the Marine Corps, I'd like to congratulate Eli Kazuma with the Patriots Award. Now, this award is dedicated to the student that has shown the greatest dedication to athletics, academics, and to the greater cause of the school, to put others above himself. Congratulations, Eli Kazuma. I hope that after high school that you have a great life and keep doing what you're doing.
Here's an update on the brackets. The winner from round three, Bruce Baumgartner's mustache.
And next, we've got decathlete, survivalist, and motivational speaker Ray Livingston's battle axe versus Coach Moody.
Moody enters the playing field, making his way towards the fridge. He opens it! Eyes the mustard, mayonnaise, Dijon, ketchup. Oh, and with resignation closes the door. He makes his way over to the pantry. Eyes the bread. Eyes the cereal. Oh, and he goes against his greater will. Oh, he's making his way back to the fridge. Will he cave in at the pressure to make another sandwich? No, he will not. He will not. Dennis Moody is going to wait on whatever's in that Instant Pot.
Hi, I'm Mr. Peterson, PE teacher here at Heritage High School. As I present the top male and female T365 performers for this year, I'd like to first recognize and thank all of our athletes who committed their time and efforts to prepare themselves for their individual sports seasons. In our second year with the program, we again saw increased involvement from all of our T-Wolf athletes. It's no surprise to see the teams who were most committed to the weight room showed the most increased success on the court, field, and mat. Members of our girls' volleyball, boys' basketball, and wrestling programs were among the most involved in off-season training and all experienced great improvement and success this year. I'd also like to recognize all of our spring athletes who were primed for greatness after their efforts in the weight room this year. Unfortunately, they were unable to participate in spring sports. With all the great involvement by all of our athletes, two stood out over the rest for their commitment, work ethic, and success. So with that, I'd like to congratulate our top female and male T365 performers for this year. They are sophomore Emily Mora and sophomore Israel Gonzalez. Thank you and congratulations.
Can't pass the people, can't pass the hitman.
C. Olsen. Play of the year, the perfectly executed run by Anthony Key going 50-plus yards for the touchdown at Camas.
Class 4A, fourth-ranked Camas hosting Heritage up at Doc Harris Stadium. Papermakers up 13-0, but Heritage getting on the board. The block party. And Anthony Key gone.
It's time for Hespy's Bracket Madness Semifinals. We've got Zoe digging in the sand versus Coach Gill's egg on a pizza. Let's get those votes tabulated.
And advancing to the finals, Coach Gill, egg on a pizza.
And here's semifinal round two. Baumgartner's mustache versus Coach Moody's indecision about what to eat. Let's get the votes tabulated.
And going to the finals.
Whoa. Stop. Who is even voting on this?
The panel of judges.
We have a panel of judges?
Yeah, we got a panel of judges.
Who?
Lots of people.
What people?
Steph Curry, Sabrina Ionescu, Mike Tyson, Cypher, this guy, that guy, her, people that make their own masks. Dr. Seuss character, the Mountain View Thundercloud, the Garrison Brothers, PewDiePie, Lizzo, Dad from Teen Wolf, Kylo Ren, that, Michael Jordan's yellow eyes, that rabbit that got away from Lita's dog, Billie Eilish's bad attitude, Dr. Fauci, Thanos.
And here we go, the final round, Gil versus Moody for the championship. Coach Gill is the winner!
And the winners are... Malia Thompson and Kulbir Singh. And the winners are Katie Panuetta and Capone Johnson. And the winners are the girls bowling team and Cade Gardner. And the winners are Ryan Wilkes and Braden Sittman. And the winner for the team of the year is our girls volleyball team. With an exciting match against Union. For those of you guys who are there, you know exactly what I'm talking about. To come back as we did from being down early. And wow, what an incredible win to advance into the bi-district tournament. Congratulations to all of our girls.
Well, that's it, everybody. Thank you. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, work hard, and bleed purple.
Can I still do the brackets?
I don't know.
I mean, I can check.
Okay, folks, it looks like we have one last contender versus Paul McGill.
Dr. Fauci says he's cool with it.
And what does Billie Eilish say?
She's just whispering again. I don't know what.
I'm just going to pull rank on this.
Okay.
Woods, what you got?
What?
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 Yes!
What?